Okay, we will start like before starting in Java. So we will see like theoretically why we need Java. We have so many other technologies also, right? So like why we are going to Java? What is the advantage of Java? How it will differ between some other technologies? So that kind of examples we will see. Okay. So you have any idea about a C language or any?
Well, I'm also in the computer background, right? But
Okay.
it's not that I have a, it's, I took C++ and all this, but it's not that, it's just like, you know, in a college, so just a
Okay.
primary.
Yeah, just you have some idea, right? C programming, you did something long back. Okay. The first one is right. So if you see like whatever you know, like C programming, right? What you will do? So before writing the C program, you need to understand hardware. If you see, if you go back to your C program, right? We used to use like a malloc, C alloc. There are some keywords in C language. So what is the purpose of the C language, right? If you are trying to create some variables means which will store some data. When you are trying to assign some data, right, we need to create some variable kind of thing. So where we need to store that variables, what kind of data it is storing, what is the default value? So basically we need to understand the memory of your system in case of C language. How much?
Correct.
So what kind of data you are trying to save, where the data is saving, where is the memory location? So these and all we so basically we need to understand the memory location structure in case of C language. Okay, when you are writing the program, you need to understand the memory location and all in case of C language. But whereas in case of Java, you no need to care about memory location, where it is saving, how to save and all. Just write a variable like this. Slowly we will see later, A equal to 10. That's all. You no need to care where it is saving, and what is the memory locations and all. You no need to understand. Basically, you
Correct.
no need to understand the hardware system. When you are writing the C program, you need to understand the hardware system. The memory locations and all you need to understand properly, then only you can able to write the programming. Otherwise, you are not able to write. So this is one of the difference. So in case of Java, you no need to understand the memory locations. Just directly write the programming. And backend side, we have a one of the machine called JVM. So what it will do? It will take care of the memory location where we need to save the data, from where we need to pick the data, where you are saving the data, from where we need to retrieve the data, that and all, it will be taken care by JVM in case of Java.
Okay.
But whereas in case of C, you need to take care. So developer need to take care all those things, where the data is storing, from where we need to retrieve it. So basically, we need to have some idea about hardware system.
Okay.
But whereas in case of Java, you no need to care about hardware system. Just write a programming. JVM will take care of that memory interaction and all. So that is one of the advantage Java is having. So that is one of the advantage. So you got some idea, right? So
Correct.
in case of C language, you need to understand the memory location also. Whereas in case of Java, you no need to understand any memory locations.
When you see the memory location, are you referring to the computer hard drive and all, right?
Yes,
Or the
you need to understand what is the memory location where the data got saved, what is the
right.
default value, how when you are trying to retrieve the data again, we need to go back to that particular memory location and we need to retrieve it.
Correct, okay.
So this is one of the basic difference. But if you say this is a disadvantage, why? Because we need to understand the hardware system and all compared to C and Java. So Java is having some advantage, correct? But if you say in a different way, there is a disadvantage also. See, if you retrieve the data directly from the memory location, it is very fast. I mean to say, C language is very fast.
Okay.
Java is slow.
Because it's not in the hardware.
Correct. Why? Because C is very fast. Why? Because directly we are dealing with memory location and we are retrieving the data.
Correct.
But whereas in case of Java, we are not dealing with memory locations. So JVM will take care of, some other person will take care. So here maybe you can say some third party, third person are involving to get the data in case of Java. So that's what you can say, Java is a bit slow compared to C language.
Okay,
and I can tell you the another example. If you see in aeroplane and all, right, the hardwares in the hardware system, they are using C programming language, C language. Why? Because it will give very fast response compared to Java, but the programming is coding is very difficult. So if you see in aeroplane and all, right, so they will use C programming. Why? Because it will give fast response than Java.
Correct. Okay.
So that's what in aeroplane and all, right, you need a quick response. It should not wait for it once, 1 minute and all, correct? If you wait for 1 minute, we don't know what will happen. So that's what in aeroplane and all, they will use C language so that they can get very fast response. In all the hardware systems, most of the people will use C language to get more response.
Okay.
Means it will take very less time. Why? Because directly you are dealing with memory location and you are retrieving the data. The simple example is, say for instance, if we'll give, so you need to meet one person in New York City. So if you know the address, door number, street number, everything, then it is very easy, right? So you can able to go to that particular street, door number, and you can able to meet the person.
Correct.
Say for instance, you don't know the door number, you know only the street number, then what you have to do?
It's going to take little time to get to that person.
So it will take some time. You need to go each and every street and you need to look for your person. So because in case of C language, directly you know the address of the data, memory location of the data.
Correct.
So that's what it is, very fast. But whereas in case of Java, it's not like that. It is a little bit different. So you'll see some slowness, but programming is very easy. So that is one of the basic difference. Okay. And now go back to the second one. Second one is, right, so Java is compile one time. So there is a concept called compile and all. Compile one time. And so first point is clear, right? The memory location, the difference between Java and you can say C language.
Correct. So yeah, memory, I got it.
Okay. Right. The second point is, right, in case of Java, write program once. Write program once, okay, and compile one time and run n number of time. So you mean to say we will write program one time and we will compile one time and we are going to run the same program n number of times.
Okay.
So we will write only one time program, we'll compile one time, and next time onwards, you no need to do these steps. Just run always.
Okay.
This is one advantage. For other languages, right? If you say C and all, right? So what it will do, every time we need to compile and run. So every time we need to do these steps. We need to compile and run. Compile and run.
Mm-hmm.
But whereas in case of Java, only one time you have to compile, and next time onward just run directly. So run means executing the programming.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
So we can able to write program one time, compile one time, and run n number of times.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the another advantage. So this point is clear?
Correct. Mm-hmm.
Okay, and let's suppose, say for instance, so another point is Java is kind of platform independent. So what is this platform independent? Let's say for instance, I'm using Windows operating system, correct?
Mm-hmm.
So I will write a program. I will compile in my machine. We will see slowly what is compile and all. What is compiling means, basically we are converting the, so this, so basically we are compiling the human readable code into the byte code. So that is called compilation. So human readable code into byte code. Byte code means which will understand the machine, ones and zeros.
Correct.
So ones and zeros we will not able to understand, right? Only machine can able to understand, hardware can able to understand.
Correct.
Okay, so that we will see later. So basically what I'm trying to do, what I'm trying to say, so whatever the code I have written in my machine in Windows operating system, the same code will work in any platform.
Correct.
So you can take in Mac, you can take some other operating system, Unix, Linux, Solaris, everywhere it will work.
Correct.
So it's not depending on any platform.
Correct.
So that is the one of the advantage of Java, right? In any platform, and it will work in any other platform also. You no need to change anything. So okay. That is one of the another advantage. So this is clear, right?
Correct.
So you write program in Mac and you give to Windows or Linux or Solaris, anything, it will work.
Mm-hmm.
So that is another advantage of, I mean, Java language.
It works on any platform, right?
Yes, it will work in any platform. You don't need to care about, okay, I'm going to give Mac, I need to write like this. So you don't no need to care. So you write program once, and then you can give that program or to anyone. No need to care about the what platform they're using. You no need to bother. So that is one of the advantage of Java language. For if you compare with some other different languages, so there is a difference. For each language, you will get a difference. For C, we need to follow this syntax. Sorry. For Windows, we need to follow this syntax. And for Unix, you need to follow this syntax. So there is a difference. But for Java, there is no such kind of difference. So you can write in any platform, and then it will work in any other platform also.
Mm-hmm.
So this point is clear, right? The third point.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, other point is, C is like kind of object oriented language. What is object and all, we will see it later. Let's suppose in newer program, so for instance, this is your program. Okay, this is your program, and this is your program parts, sub parts.
Mm-hmm.
So there is some three parts is there.
Correct.
Okay. So say friends, at any point of instance, maybe it will execute, or it will execute, or it will execute. On a need base, you are going to call which part we need to execute. Correct?
Mm-hmm.
So basically it will not follow the sequence. So if you see some other languages, they will execute from the top to down bottom always. But whereas Java, it will not follow this approach. So it will follow on a need base. So sometime it will execute only the second part, sometime it will execute only the third part.
Mm-hmm.
So basically it is not, it will not follow the sequence program, it will follow the object oriented program on a need base. So whatever portion you want to execute, you can able to call only that particular portion.
Okay.
But mm-hmm. other languages, what they will do, whether you need or not need, but it will execute from the starting to ending.
Mm-hmm.
It will try to execute everything. It's basically it is following sequence programming.
Correct.
Other languages. But whereas in case of Java, you no need to execute everything. Just you need, you can execute whatever you want. Rest you can ignore.
All right.
So that is the another advantage of Java. That one you can say, basically we are considering, we are creating entire thing as an object. In, after that, we are invoking whatever piece of code we need it.
Right.
So this is the, I mean, another advantage of Java. So basically, Java will not follow the sequence programming. It will not follow the sequence programming. So you can able to create an object and invoke which portion of program you want to execute it. I want to execute only this portion, or I want to execute only this portion. You can able to do it.
Right.
So this is another advantage of Java. So this is clear, right?
Correct. Just like any time that you wanted to, any block that you wanted to call,
correct. You can call. Yes. At any point of time, if you want to call with any language, any portion of your program, you can able to call it.
Correct.
But whereas if you see some other languages, what it will do, it will always execute from the top to down.
Right, it goes to the sequence. Right?
Sequence program, but that will, if the, in that case, we need to write so many conditions. In this case, we should not execute this one. In this case, we have to execute only this one. We need to maintain the code in such a way to skip some portion of the code, correct?
Correct.
But whereas here, you no need to do that thing. So you can able to always call what portion of code you want to execute at any point of time.
Correct.
So that is one of the advantage. And another advantage of Java is so say for instance you have written a program in Java, okay, and you want to talk with C language. So you have written a program in Java language and I have written a program in C language. So if you want to talk with, if you want to call C language from Java program, it is possible. So basically it is having an ability to interact with foreign languages.
So if even though you are using Java, you can call the different languages in Java?
Correct. You can able to talk with C also.
Okay. So is there any other languages?
Yes, it will support, there is a concept called native library.
Okay.
So in that case, so you can able to talk with some different languages. Basically, it will provide the environment. So to which language you want to connect. So we need some additional library or environment to connect or to talk with that foreign language. So Java is having that kind of ability also.
So just a quick question. It's just a job related. Whenever the developer is developing the application, right? When they do the backend of the application, when they do the configuration, right? So at that time, they use a between the database and the application, they use Java, right? For the connecting.
Correct. Yes.
So that's the whole thing. Is just the this message, right?
You can say this is Java programming. What are you have written?
Mm-hmm.
Correct. And there is a different database, Oracle, Sybase, or MySQL, whatever. This is a DB.
Mm-hmm.
So from Java, you are going to connect to database, correct? So how we are going to connect So there we are going to use some different APIs and all different framework. There are so many things is there.
Okay.
So you will write a program. So in you, by using simple Java, you can able to connect. You can able to connect to database also.
Mm-hmm.
So in this case, we need to understand the hardware system and all, right? So to which server we need to connect and all, what is the IP address and also. In that case, we are going to use some C language to get the memory locations and all.
Huh, okay.
So in that case, we are using C programming to get the memory location. Why? Because Java language don't have that facility to get the memory locations and all. So it is taking help from C language and it is getting the memory locations. C language having that ability to get the memory locations. But whereas in case of Java, doesn't support the memory locations. So in that case, what it will do, it will call the C programming and it will get the memory locations.
Okay.
So in case of whenever interacting with some different machines or anything, right? So it needs some hardware understanding and all. So in that case, it will interact with the C language and it will try to get the memory locations and all.
Okay.
So this is one of the, reason why they introduced this foreign language concept.
Okay, I see.
This is one advantage or one reason, and in some particular reason, right? So I will tell you that there is some other reason also. Let's suppose you take the same example. You can say this is one entity, correct? So inside that we have some three different blocks. This is one block, this is another block, and third block. Okay. So I created one entity called E1, you can say, which is having three blocks. Okay, three blocks. Okay. And another person, what he is trying to do, he is trying to create entity 2, which is having three blocks. It is similar kind of the existing one.
Correct.
He is trying to create a duplicate thing. But maybe user 2 don't know, like there is some already existing entity. It is kind of similar one.
It could be a find.
User 2 is not able to find. Like already there is existing entity. E1 is like a E2. User 2 don't know, but what it will do, right, back end side. So at finally we need to save this data in one particular memory location, correct? So say for instance the memory location is M1. So this entire entity is saved into some memory location called M1. Memory address. Okay, so the M, some different person also is trying to create same kind of entity. Everything is same, the data, everything is same. So what Java will do, it will not create a new entity. So what it will do, it will point to the existing entity. Why? Because it's a duplicate kind of work, right? Duplicate data you are trying to save, correct?
Correct.
So how you know this thing? Java will use backend side C programming to get the memory locations and all, to get the data and all, where the data is saving and what is that memory location and all. Then what it will do, it will not create a new entity, it will point to the existing entity. But user perspective, user don't know, correct? So if you say this is the memory area, so this entire thing is just considered a memory area. So where they are saving, entities are saving. So this entity one is saving in this particular memory location, M1. Okay. Entity two also we are saving into the same memory location.
Right.
Why? Because it's kind of duplicate thing, correct? We don't need to create another location, M2. If you are creating M2 means unnecessarily we are creating two, we are doing two duplicate things, correct? So we should not do, right?
Right. Just putting it in the one folder and then you can call
yes,
it.
Yes, correct, correct. Maybe user don't know. User think maybe my entity is different. Each user is thinking, or maybe his own entity is different. But if you see the backend side, it is not creating two different entities. So how this thing is happening? Basically, Java language will use C programming language to deal with the memory backend side. So who will do this one? It's kind of JVM. So it's kind of, you can say some third person. So there is a delay, right? Third person means there is a delay. So because the developer is not directly involving with memory location. So there is a delay here. So this is the first point, whatever I told you that, right? Advantage. So JVM will take care of all those things. Do we need to create a new memory location, or is there any existing memory location which is having same kind of data?
Yeah.
Correct? So this is the another difference. So C language, so basically Java will support other foreign language to interact with other foreign languages and execute it and get the results back.
Yeah.
So this point is clear, right?
Correct.
So these are the some of the advantage, and there are some advantages also. So when we're starting in Java, right? So that time when I will explain that advantage, you will get more sense. So this is theoretically whatever I told. This is just theoretically. So this memory locations and hardware, all those things. It's theoretically. So there are some other advantages also. When I will start exert Java, then I can able to explain you some more advantage of Java compared to some other languages.
Okay.
So this point is clear, right? Why we need C language in Java? Right.
Yes, it's just a substitute language to connect with the other database. And
correct, correct. Yes, yes. Connect to a database and reading the memory location. All those things. In that case, we are using C language. We are taking help from C language, and we are we are using C language help, and we are getting the memory locations. Why? Because memory locations means if you see your memory, your system memory RAM, you can say RAM or hardware. So the memory locations is a hexadecimal address. It's like this. So you are not able to understand anything the memory location where the data is saving,
right?
But C language can able to understand where the data is saved, what is the memory location, so how much portion of memory is occupied and how much portion memory is empty.
Correct, because the C language is able to read the hardware.
Correct, it's can able to read the hardware. So that's what C language is very fast, and Java language is a bit slow compared to C language. But C language is difficult to code, but Java language is easy to code.
Okay.
So based on that, we need to pick one language. So we need to, because we are developing web applications, correct? For web application, if even if the response will come for 5-6 seconds, there is no that much impact. But whereas in case of aircraft and all, if the response came after 5-6 seconds, there may be some impact, correct? So that's what we are using. I mean, in case of web development, we are using Java language, and we are using C language in case of like a flight or hardware system and all, we are using C language. Okay, and before that, before starting to Java, we will see the basic versions. How many versions is there? Is there any version kind of, if you take any software, right? So there is a version, correct? They will keep releasing the versions. So what we will do just before starting the Java, we will see what is the different versions is there? How many versions is there? What is the basic version and what is the latest version?
Okay.
So far, how many versions they got released, and what is the different? On what basis they will release it? Who will release it? Who is owning it? Some background.
This Oracle is the owner, right?
Yes. So right now, who is the owner of Java? Oracle Corporation. Mm-hmm. And previously, it was Sun Microsystem.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. And initially, it was Sun Microsystem, and in somewhere 2011 or 12, I guess they acquired. So initially, it was Sun. After that, these people acquired Oracle. And now they are maintaining all those things. So far, right, if you say the versioning system, so now currently who is owning this JDK software and all? So Oracle Corporation.
Correct.
Uh-huh. And previously it was owning by Sun Microsystem.
Hmm.
Okay. And you come back to the versions and all. If you say the latest, we will start with. So first we will see the latest version. The latest version is 1.8.
This is the latest version that is having in currently.
Currently it's in market.
Uh-huh.
And there is another version will come. There is another version. It's supposed to come in December 2016, but due to some technical reason, they postponed to March 2017.
Oh, okay.
It is called 1.9. It will come.
Okay.
So currently in market, right now we have a latest version is 1.8. And in next year, you will get one more version, 1.9.
Hmm.
And the old version is, you can say, they started with 1.2, I think, 1.2. That is not working properly. So the working version, 1.4. The initial version, 1.2. Later on, the working version means which will give some benefit is the base version, you can say 1.4. So initially they started with 1.2, first version, and they didn't see much useful things. Then they introduced 1.4. So here you will see a lot of more features, 1.4. After that, what they introduced? I mean, they introduced 1.45. So 1.5 we used to call as a 5.0 also. So basically, after 1.4, they introduced 1.5. This 1.5 we used to call as a 5.0 also version. And in case of 1.5, you will see a lot of new features.
Hmm.
After that, subsequently, they keep on releasing the 1.6. And 1.7, but there is no much useful features. Finally, they released 1.8. Here you will see more meaningful features.
Okay.
So currently, whatever it is there in market, 1.8 is having more features rather than 1.5. But 1.5, 6 and 7 versions is there, but there is no much useful features. So this is the JDK, basically Java software versions. They started with 1.2 and after that 1.4, 1.5, 6, 7, 8, that's all. And 9 will come next year. And in this version, which versions are the best? I can say 1.4, 1.5 and 1.8. We will see what is the best, why I can say best, or what is the new features that we will see later slowly. So these are the basic versions. So if you want to download these softwares, what you have to do? You have to go to just we will see the versions when each version got released.
Yeah.
If you see here, right? Mm-hmm. So first version they had released in 94.
Wow.
Beta version 94. 1.0, 1.2, 3.4 version. So this is the best version I can say. And after that, the best version is 5. And 6 and 7, you didn't see much useful things.
But in a corporation, they use it, right?
Yes, people are using, but there is no much features here.
Okay, but in terms of the compiling and all this stuff,
yeah, everything is compiling and all, everywhere it is there. But there should be some benefits, right? If you see Android, every time they are releasing KitKat, there are so many versions they are releasing, right?
Right.
But what is the difference? You will see one or two features.
Correct.
They will say performance issues. We fixed. They will say performance issues. But we will not notice that much. Correct?
Mm-hmm.
They keep on releasing the, if you say, even say Samsung, if you take Samsung phones or Apple phones, they keep on releasing the version. Correct? iPhone 6, 7, 8, 9, something like that. They keep on releasing the versions. But what is the difference? Sometimes they will give big screen and more pixel camera. So these are the advantages, correct? The similar way here also they will give some more features. But if you see the feature wise, so JDK 5 is the best one and 1.4, after that 7. And in between they are trying to release 6 and 7, but there is no much useful features.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the versioning system. And so far 9, right? So we didn't release. So if you see here, 9, you can able to understand when they're going to release it. So they planned for 17 JDK 9,
right?
So because they initially planned in 2016, but due to some issues, so they are not able to release it, so they postponed to next year March. Also, they have a plan for 10 also. See, the 10 is there, but so far they don't have any plan to release it. They have a plan for 10 also, JDK 10, but they didn't mention so far when they are going to release it.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the version system. So far we have an idea. I mean, we have the existing or working version is JDK 8. And if you see here, they mentioned only in, if you see here, 8.8. So what is the best new features in 8? So they will mention in wiki page. See, JDK 8 features update.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the new features they got introduced in JDK 8 compared to 7 and 6 and 5. These many features are there. So we'll see these features. Well, we'll see slowly what is the advantage of JDK 8 compared to older versions like 6, 5, 7 and all.
Okay.
And whenever they are trying to release any version, they will give a list of the advantage of that particular version. See, the 7 also, there is some advantage. See. This entire table will give the JDK 7 advantages. Java software. So what is mean by JDK? JDK means Java Development Kit.
Right. Uh-huh.
It's kind of Java software. So this is the JDK 6 features. 5 features. So like that, for every version, they will give some benefits also. So if you see here, version changes, updates, like that, they will release the version and they'll give the features. If you use the new features, this is the advantage.
Right.
So this is the versions. Okay, now second point is from where we need to download the software. So from where we need to download the software. So if you want to, like previously we discussed, right? So this JDK software is owning by Oracle people, correct?
Correct.
So previously it was Microsystem. Now we need to, it was acquired by Oracle system, Oracle Corporation. Mm-hmm. So what you have to do? So you need to download, go to the oracle.com. From there we can able to download what kind of version you want, whether you are going to use Windows or Mac or something else.
Okay.
Even from here you can able to download the old version also. If you see right now, what is the latest version is 8, right?
Uh-huh.
So if you want to download 7, 6, you can able to.
Okay. So which one will you planning to work?
First, I will start with 4. I will start with 4.
Oh, okay.
Then I will explain what is the difference between 4 and 5.
Okay.
Then I will explain difference between 5 and 6 and 7, little bit changes. Then I will compare 5, 6, 7 with 8.
Okay.
You need to understand, I mean, everything, right? So what is the advantage of 4 and 5? It's just for our knowledge purpose.
Okay.
So why we need to understand this one? If you go for interview and all, they will ask these questions. Yeah. If you say I'm using JDK 1.5, they will ask immediately, tell me what is the benefits of 1.5 compared to 1.4.
Right, you have to know the differences.
Yes, and if you say I'm using 1.8, okay, tell me why you are using 1.8, why you are not using 1.675. They will put that question, correct? You should be in a position to say something. You should not say I don't know, correct?
Mm-hmm.
So there should be some reason, right, why you are using this version.
Mm-hmm.
So like that, what I will do, we will start with 1.4 and I will compare 1.5 with 1.4.
Okay.
No, later on, we will see 1.6, what is the changes? And also we will compare with 1.8 also. So that you will get some idea of all this versioning.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, there is no much difference, but still we have to understand the differences. What is the advantage? Okay. And if you want to download the software like JDK Java Development Kit, so what you have to do? So you need to enter into the Oracle Corporation website, and from here you can able to see all the versions. See, you can able to download even 1.5 also. If you see here, it will support, you can able to download all the earlier version also.
Okay. So it doesn't matter if I'm using the Mac or Windows, right? The version will be compatible, right? Does it matter?
It is a matter when we are trying to download a software, right?
Uh-huh.
So we have to select what kind of operating system you are going to use.
Okay, all right. No, I thought that this is, since it is a language, does it matter?
So first time when we are trying to install, the JDK software is independent of like a platform. After that, you can write the program that is independent of platform.
Right. Okay.
So I'll show you how to select that one. If you see here, right, say for instance JDK 7, first we need to accept the license and agreements, accept,
mm-hmm.
Then you accept the terms and conditions, After that, you had to see which version you are using. You are using Mac or Solaris, Linux or Windows. Did you see there? Linux, mm-hmm. Solaris, Mac and Windows. Correct? Right. After that, you will see, after operating system, you will see the bit. 64-bit or 86.
Or 32.
So you had to select what is your versioning system and click on the software. If you see here. Yeah. Then click this one and it will download. It will download.
Okay. I think I already have that because I'm using the...
Correct. Just I'm showing you so that this is the official way to download it. So and you can select, I mean, whatever version you want and for which platform you are trying to download. So you can select it and you can download accordingly. So here you will get all versions, JDK 7 or any versions. So first what you had to do, you have to download the, I mean, the software from the this website.
Right.
After that, how to install it? So while for installation, how to install it? And while installing, we need to follow the some of the steps. So now you have download is completed. Now the second part is installation. You know, you have any idea about Eclipse?
Yeah, I'm heavily using Eclipse.
Yeah. So from day one, I will not use Eclipse. I will use only Notepad.
Okay.
So first for 1 or 2 days, maybe 2 days, I will not use Eclipse. I want to use only this Notepad.
Okay.
I will write a simple program. I will compile it and I will show you the output. Next day after 2 days, right? Then I will take an Eclipse. Then I will write the same program by using Eclipse. I'll show the difference. Then basically I want to show you the difference between Notepad and what is the advantage of Eclipse. Basically I want to show you.
Right.
Directly if I'll start Eclipse, you will not understand the advantage of Eclipse, correct?
Correct.
If I'll start with Notepad and you'll see the steps, how many steps we had to do. After that, later on, I will start using the Eclipse. How many steps I can minimize. How many steps I can minimize by using Eclipse, that we will see it later. Okay, that anyway, that is a later part. So right now you can download the software from this URL. Okay. After that, I will explain you how to install it.
Okay. This is the, which version you want me to download? Sorry again.
You can download any version. Okay. Maybe you can download 8.
Okay, so then should I go with the 8? I believe I do have the 8.
Yes, you can download it, 8. So here there is another feature also is there. You can download 8. So you can use, you can able to downgrade yourself to any version.
Okay.
If you have a 8, right? So you can able to use 7, 6, 5 also.
Okay.
So there is an option. So if you want to code with only 1.5 environment, if you want to use it, you can able to use it. You can see, so backward compatibility is there always.
Okay.
It's same thing. If you see the Android programming, you have a different versions, correct? So there is an Android app. So you have now you downloaded one of the app from the from the internet. Okay, so it version is the old version. So what is that KitKat or something, whatever, right? So the KitKat version you use KitKat version and you developed an app. So that application should work in all the versions, either old versions or new version, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, there is no use. WhatsApp. Say for instance, you are using WhatsApp. So when you are trying to install the WhatsApp, so the maybe the WhatsApp was developed with the old version, 1.2. So but that should work in latest version also. Otherwise, it's no use, right?
Mm-hmm.
It should work in older version as well as newer version. So there should be a compatibility. The similar way Java also having that kind of compatibility. So if you have a 1.8, if you don't want to use 1.8 features, you want to use only 1.5 features, you can able to use it. So that's what you download 1.8, and we will use subsequent versions slowly one by one. So you download 1.8, and what I will do tomorrow, how to install, what are the steps we need to follow while installation, and how to check whether the installation is successful or not.
Okay.
So there is a steps we need to follow while installation. Once the installation is done successfully, how to check whether the installation is success or not? Just to ensure from your side.
Okay.
So that we will see tomorrow.
Okay, sure, definitely.
Okay, and tomorrow we will connect same time. Not tomorrow, day after, sorry.
Okay, day after tomorrow.
Yes, yes, tomorrow we'll, I need to connect with Mustafa. And day after I will connect.
Okay, so Mustafa has almost, how many, he has few more class or?
For Mustafa, I think AngularJS is completed. I need to take web service, maybe some two, three classes maximum.
Okay.
Also after that, we will continue.
Okay, sure.
Okay. And we will connect the day after same time.
Okay, sure. Definitely.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Yeah. Thanks. Bye.
Thank you very much. Munahar, can you forward me this information?
Yeah, sure. Definitely. Yeah.
Yeah. So that I can.
I will give this note and the video also.
Okay.
Okay, this video link also I'll give. Just I'll upload it to YouTube or somewhere. I'll give the link to you. You can have visit this video plus this note, whatever we discussed.
Okay, sure. Beautiful. Okay.
Yeah, sure. Fine. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Yeah. Bye.